Hello and welcome to Kentucky Brew Reviews. I'm Radar.
Special K, and tonight we're doing some weird Christmas shit.
That's apt. That is correct.
I was at a Myers, and they had both of these things, so I bought them. Radar here has Bell's underwear. It's Two Hearted Ale American Pale Ale.
In a can.
It's got fish on can.
Fish on can.
And fish on boxers. But here's the problem I just noticed. I was really into these until I noticed that it says swag on it. Then I'm not.
Oh, no.
Now I'm not into it.
But on the other hand, Special K has got these delicious craft beer Jelly Bellies that also come in a beer can. They don't say swag on them. Does that make them better or worse?
$6? $5.
Oh, it's alcohol free. It says so right here.
Yeah. So, $6 for the underwear, $5 for these. Now, I bought these at Myers. They had Corona and Budweiser, and I saw one pair of these. I was like, there's no way they had my size. They had my size.
Look at you.
I'm an XL in the undies.
Are you gonna model it for the camera?
No, I'm going to pull them out of here, though.
I think you should model it for the camera.
Oh, look at that. Little Bell's logo?
We could call it Dudoir.
Look at that little Bell's logo. It's not even, like, painted on.
Is it a patch?
It's a patch.
Okay.
On the ass.
I'm okay with that.
If you look at them in the back, those are very woodsy. I like them. And then the front, I don't know why they felt the need to put the swag and the skulls on there. But they did. They feel like pretty good undies. They don't have a wiener hoe, which is disappointing. It's padded. The wiener is padded, which is interesting.
Well, God knows you need that.
It's like double. It's got double wiener protection there, but there's nothing there. But the problem
it's just
is
just in case of drips, right?
Yeah. I really like the fish. I like the wood scene. I don't like the swag on the front. I'll say that. I will. If they're awful after I try them on, we will find out. But for $6, it's not too bad for undies. I mean, for like weird fancy undies.
I mean, yeah, it's one of those things you get as like a
stocking
stuffer.
Stuffer.
Yeah. Like, I would probably wrap that and be like, this is a gift. This is your $5 gift.
Oh, I think Swag is the brand that makes it.
Oh, that makes sense, because I've never seen anything from Bell's that's got skulls on it or the word swag. I'm a little bit disappointed in these. Like, listen. You hear that?
Yeah. Those are $5, by the way.
Sounds like there's jelly beans inside here. And there are, but they're like...
Well, they gotta be in a package.
They're packaged individually.
It's not an airtight... Oh, God.
They're bubbles.
Are they all the same
flavor? For some reason, they're triangular.
Oh, good. We only have to open one pack. Thank God. They're all the same.
You sure we're not going to open all of these?
No.
So, feed them to Mingo right now?
170 calories for all...
Damn.
That's 170 calories.
Man,
oh, wait, no,
this,
sorry.
This is the Tide Pod of candies. Look at this thing.
I lied. It's five. It's the entire can's 170 calories. So, I feel like you're paying, in this situation, you're paying $3 for the can. You're paying $2 for the jelly beans?
Not even that. Jelly beans are not that expensive.
$6 for a pair of underwear is not that bad. You're paying, you know, $1, $2 for the can.
I'd buy that. I'd buy that for, like, everyone I know that drinks beer. I'd be down.
I'm just glad that they had craft beer. I was concerned that they were just going to have non-craft beer. So these jelly beans look weird as shit.
Why? Yeah, they are, in fact, gold.
They
smell like...
Old beer.
They smell like a can of beer you left open for like an hour.
I'm trying to figure out if it's my hands because I was just washing dishes.
No, no. My hands are clean.
They dirty dish towel.
Not a fan.
That flavor kicks in late.
Mm-hmm. Took a minute. I didn't think it was going to have a flavor for a minute. I was like, it's just gelatin-flavored candy.
You ready for this? Bananas?
Why did they add a banana flavor to this?
They got that Coors Light flavor down pat.
Why? It does taste like... even when you, like, put it in your mouth, chew it up, and then breathing through your nose. It just smells like stale beer when you breathe in through your nose.
It does. It's too sweet, but it is jelly bean, so I get it.
Yeah, like it's beer-flavored candy. Does it taste like candy? Yes. Does it taste like beer? Yes.
Sore.
I was kind of mad. I thought it was just going to be loose jelly beans inside of a can.
No, they would be stale. This can is definitely not airtight.
I mean, it had the thing around it.
Look, now you can mess with somebody. It's...
It does look more like a real can than that one.
At least put like a coin hole in it so this is useful for something. Like...
You could cut your own coin hole in it. It's not a big deal.
These jelly beans, eh. $5. So that means they're $1 a bag for these jelly beans.
Mm-hmm.
For these...
Well, you're also buying a can.
80 cents a bag.
That's not worth it.
No. So,
we go and buy you some beer underwear instead. Oh,
at this time of the year, they're doing alcohol like sets and beer sets.
Mm-hmm.
I recommend getting those for your beer lovers.
What's going on with that can? Did you crush it in there?
I don't know what I did. Anyway, yeah, they make these kits. Like, Myers also sold some beer kits. I didn't buy them because we had already reviewed them all before. A lot of liquor stores are selling liquor kits, you know what I mean? So, like, it'll be like
a bottle of
like Maker's Mark with two glasses or something like that. It's a nice gift, right? Because you get the extra glasses.
Right.
They throw them in. They're pretty, a lot of times they're cheaper than just buying a bottle of Maker's Mark. So
you can get like a Jack Daniels bottle with two glasses and a flask, and it'll be like
$1.
It'll be like $20.
Yeah.
They're usually around the $20 region. They like to keep it in there. They have a Jägermeister version, which I got one time. Good memories.
I'm sure.
I brought it on vacation with us. Remember that?
Yeah, we've done these in the past, stuff like this. But yeah, I just saw these two products, and I was like, let's just, for shits and giggles, let's do a review on them.
I feel like that's actually a good choice. Like, the beer underwear is kind of funny.
No, and they're legit. They're legit underwear. Like I said, I would.
Yeah, I was expecting that to be like super like pilly and just not good.
I've got things similar to this before, and they were shitty quality, and they were like boxers, and your nuts hang out of the bottom of them and stuff like that. These are legit.
I mean,
good.
Like normally when you get gimmicky stuff like that, it is crappy. But Bell's makes good beer, and I guess now they also make good underwear.
It has the Bell's logo in the underwear. It has it sewed on the patch like a boxer would have on like a logo. I'm down. The waistband's surprisingly pleasant.
It's a pleasant waistband? That's actually, that's not bad. Does the bottom come off? It seems like it comes off. What? It just says swag on the back.
Why? All right. They're cotton and not that breathable nylon material. They almost feel like that.
Full cotton. Are they actually cotton? They don't look cotton at all.
They feel cotton. Oh, no, they are 92% polyester.
Yeah, I was about to say, there's no way that's cotton.
8% elastane. What I was talking about before is they, you know how they have the cooling, like the Under Armour ones and stuff that are like really thin and, you know, make your boys sweat less?
First of all, that's not cotton either.
Well, that's my point. That's what I was saying.
Oh, I got
you. It's not that material, is what I'm saying. But it's also, it's similar to cotton, but it's more stretchy, so.
The bottom comes off, but I can't get it off.
I don't think it actually comes off.
It does. I got it like a quarter of the inch, I got a quarter inch out. 100%. Look inside. There you go. Ah! Told you.
Think harder, not smarter.
Look here. Just because you're a tool-using monkey doesn't mean I'm one.
Apparently not. I eat all those jelly beans like a man.
They're not good.
No. All right. So, would we recommend the undies? Yes, yeah. To a beer lover. Would we recommend the draft beer-flavored jelly beans?
No.
They're awful. And they're too expensive. $5.
They taste like stale beer. Who's doing this?
Yeah. So, get the undies if they're in the box of briefs. The only thing I don't like the swag on the front. I don't like the wiener hoe. But, like, it doesn't have a wiener
hole. Lack of wiener hole?
Yeah, but I'd wear it. I mean, I'd still wear them. I'm going to wear them.
If we go camping and you walk out of your tent wearing one of those, I will shoot you in the face. Actually. Realistically.
Oh, I'm going to...
In real life.
I'm going to get a matching shirt.
Not in Minecraft.
To swag. It's mandatory.
You had better not.
All right, well, that has been our episode. If there's something you would like to see on the channel or you would like to see similar things on the show, you can leave a comment down below. Don't forget to hit that like button. I'm Special K.
I'm Radar.
Thanks for watching.